In less than 5 minutes, I will show you how to ragdoll any part of your character in Unreal Engine 5. If it's a full body mesh, a leg, or everything except one leg, you'll be able to do this for your project. So I'll just be using the default third person map. This will work for any character, but I'll be using the default Unreal Engine mannequin in case you want to use that animation. So I'll navigate to content, third person blueprints, and duplicate the third person character and give it a name, something like Jiggles, which could be a terrifying clown name, but let's go with that. Go to the world settings. If you don't have that tab, just navigate to window and you can check the world settings are turned on for you. There in world settings, under game mode, you can see that it's third person game mode, and under selected pawn, default pawn class, we can change that from third person to Jiggles or whatever character mesh you're using. Make sure you drag that in there. So when you press play, it's gonna be Jiggles and not somebody else. Let's double click the blueprint and make it in its own window. On the left hand side, you can see that there's a few items in the components tab, including the actual BP Jiggles itself, and then the mesh of the character that we're gonna be making into a ragdoll. So make sure when clicking on settings, you're actually clicking on the mesh so that ragdolls applies to the person inside the capsule, not the capsule itself. So we're gonna be looking at two settings, simulate physics, so the ragdoll falls down or wiggles as it's supposed to, and then collision, so the ragdoll collides with itself or other things in the way that we want to. Here you can see that it's called character mesh, and ragdoll is actually a built-in setting in Unreal Engine, so you can toggle that on and off whenever you want to have a ragdoll for your character. But as I've said before, physics and ragdoll have to be both enabled. Although you probably wouldn't want to use that all the time, we're gonna go to the event graph and make sure that we can enable ragdolling, disable ragdolling, or ragdoll specific body parts that you want to use. For example, if somebody shoots you in the arm, your arm can become numb for, 2 seconds before another buff or debuff takes effect. So that's something that you'll be able to set up in the input or event. So for this, I'll be using an input of a keyboard button, so I'll just be using the number 1. Make sure it's under keyboard events. The little keyboard icon is gonna say 1. Since we'll only be controlling the mesh, let's drag the mesh from the components tab. By dragging away from the mesh, we can see context sensitive functions we can use specifically with this mesh. So let's be sure we type in a set collision profile name, exactly as it says on screen. And there you connect that to the press of a button 1. So when that button is pressed, the collision profile will be set to none. So let's currently go and check that it's called character mesh at the moment, and we want to change that none into ragdoll. Make sure you capitalize exactly as it is shown on the collision presets. You can use this for ragdoll or any other functions, just make sure that the capitalization, numbers, points, spaces is always honored, otherwise it will not work. So when you finish it, you can click compile and save, and just to make sure that it's actually working and triggering, let's add in the print string and just say that it's gonna be a ragdoll activation. Obviously nothing's gonna happen yet because you're just ragdolling. You're changing the collision profile of your character, but you're not actually making it do the ragdoll animation because there's no physics applying to it. So let's go back to the mesh, drag off a set simulate physics, and that will make sure that we are simulating physics for the whole mesh. And after applying the ragdoll collision preset, simulating physics and making sure that is ticked on. Now when we press play, start walking and press 1, we'll immediately fall on our face. That's because the physics and the ragdoll are activated, and that is for the whole mesh. So the whole mesh gets detached from the capsule component of BP underscore jiggles. If you want to see that or troubleshoot that in game, you can actually unhide the capsule and see how it looks like. That's what allows you to pan the camera across because your camera is bound to the capsule and not the actual mesh component. This is important when you're trying to do something after the ragdoll is triggered because any effect you could be doing is going to be from the capsule. So yeah, now let's simulate physics from the mesh, but in this case, let's take set all bodies below simulate physics. That means anything attached to the bone will become simulated, not the whole body. So let's remove set simulate physics for the whole mesh and put in our below node. Make sure that is ticked on and you can input that back into place. You can probably delete the print strings if you want because we already know that it's functional. As you can see here, There is a pink node, which means it's a text enabled slot, same as with the Ragdoll before. If you right click on that, you can make literal name. You want to make sure you're using the exact bone name, and that will work for any mesh. So click on mesh, and under mesh on the right hand side in the details panel, if you click that little folder with the zoom glass, you can see where the skeleton is. And if you double click and open that, you'll see all the bones inside the skeleton. So for example, if you're getting something from Mixamo, it may have a different bone name. In this case, I'll use the upper arm underscore left as my bone, because everything attached to the arm, from the arm down to the pinkies, will count. I would suggest not using the pelvis or the like root bone, because that will make your whole mesh collapse. So unless it's something you're trying to go through, yeah, you can do that. But here you can see that we have a wavy left arm and it's working correctly. So when we press one, it wiggles and it continues to wiggle. So I'll just remove the print strings so they're not in the way. Copy paste the second part of it, and I will change my upper arm underscore R, so both my arms are wiggly. Make sure you connect your mesh, otherwise it won't know what parts to wiggle. So now when we run and press one, we have wobbly arms. You can do the same effect for legs and arms and anything else, as long as you're not touching the root bone. Yeah, but that's pretty much the end of the tutorial, so I hope that helps you. I can just show you some more examples. For example, if you want to undo the ragdoll effect, I'll just make a new input. Same as before, but like keyboard press 2 is gonna now undo the whole bit from the top. So just copy paste all of this down below, and I will toggle the settings back so we can actually change it during our game. Back from ragdoll, as you remember, it was called character mesh. So now we'll put in, instead of ragdoll, with character mesh, and then untick both simulate physics in the second and third blue box. This will enable us to be able to toggle on or off our wiggly arms, legs, or whatever else. So I'll just label that, and you can use this code with anything you want. You can put delay on it, you can make special effects, you can add any other triggers that you want. Pretty much works for anything. Yep, so double check everything is good. Add a print string when we're ragdolling and when we're back to normal. Now when you press play, when you press 1, it's a ragdoll arms. When you press 2, it's gonna go back to normal and gonna go full animation mode. And since we're not ragdolling the core root bone or the pelvis bone, our mesh stays inside the capsule and there's no errors, because if we do get outside the capsule, it's gonna be hard to undo the ragdolling animations because you'll be offset, but I can show that in a bit. For example, let's take the pelvis bone and do something that we don't want to do, because it is a bit chaotic. Like, you may want this effect, but it is chaotic. It's hard to reattach it back to capsule. Like, you'll have to do a little bit of coding and mess around to make it back where it's supposed to be. I'll just change this to pelvis exactly as it was labeled before. Write pelvis on both of these and then play and show you what happens if you change the root bone or something close to the root bone. Press 1 and we flop. But now if we press 2, it will rebind the mesh offset to the capsule. So that's same if in the viewport you drag the mesh away from the capsule, which would give you really weird effects. So that's a bit buggy, so I wouldn't suggest doing that. You can definitely use it for spines, even if they're slightly offset or not, because that will attach everything above the spine in the direction from the bone outwards. Now we have the waking up in the morning, groggy, going to get your coffee, or I don't know, a low effort zombie animation if you don't really want to animate the hands. The best part is it still keeps the blueprint and the whole advanced blueprint system for the legs. So you still get the full movement, jumping, crouching, whatever else you add to it, but you still get the floppy arm effect. The same can be repeated with the lower part of the body, because the root bone is actually close to the pelvis. If you fully ragdoll the legs, the top of your animation will still stick to the mesh and you'll be able to have ghost legs as you're running around. Your legs will still be dragging behind you, which you can enable and disable in the same way. So don't be afraid to experiment. Put any body parts you want, any appendages on tentacles or fins or whatever else. And yeah, I hope this was helpful, and check out the rest of my channel to look at my slime game. I'll be coming out with devlog 1 pretty soon, so be happy to see you there. Thank you, bye!